You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. Who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert, with its serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion, for he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat, he fills you. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinance to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Jesus said to the crowds, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is real food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy feast day to Corpus Christi Parish. Today is the feast of the Body and Blood of Christ, formerly called Corpus Christi, and it's our parish's feast day. Of course, Corpus Christi is Latin for Body of Christ. In the old days, there were separate feasts for the Body of Christ, Corpus Christi, and the Blood of Christ. The Feast of the Precious Blood was celebrated on July 1st. After the Second Vatican Council, though, the two feasts were joined together and it became the Feast of the Body and Blood of Christ. But the Feast of the Body of Christ, Corpus Christi, was always the more major feast, and so we sometimes still refer to it as the Feast of the Solemnity of Corpus Christi. And our parish, of course, retains its name, Corpus Christi. We are Corpus Christi. We are the Body of Christ. On the Feast of the Holy Trinity one year, Pope Benedict XVI said, "We must commit ourselves to live our communion with God and with one another. We are called to receive and to pass on the truths of faith in a spirit of harmony, to live our love for each other and for everyone, sharing joys and sufferings and learning to seek and to grant forgiveness." And Pope Benedict continues, "In a word, we have been given the task of building parish communities that are more and more like families, and to evangelize not only by word, but by radiation." That word radiation sounds dangerous, but the Pope is saying, in other words, that as a parish family, we must radiate love, and that we draw others to the church and to Christ by radiating this love, which is the love of Jesus himself. It is the love of Christ himself, because in sharing the body and blood of Christ, we become his body, his loving presence in the world. You might want to check out our Sunday bulletin on our parish's website. We still can print copies for you, but you can find the bulletins and other information on our parish's website. And there are many quotations in this week's bulletin which speak of the church as the body of Christ. The quotation begins with one from St. Paul. "Is not the bread we break a sharing in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, many though we are one body, for we partake of the one loaf. You then are the body of Christ." And taking that teaching to heart, we truly are Corpus Christi. We are the body of Christ. We are Jesus for one another and for all who come to celebrate with us. People experience God's love for them through us. And the Eucharist is a sacrament of unity. As St. John Paul II said, it is important to be mindful that communion with Christ is deeply tied to our communion with our brothers and sisters. The Eucharist is the sacrament of unity. And Pope Benedict XVI said, "In sacramental communion, I become one with the Lord, like all the other communicants. Union with Christ is also union with all those to whom he gives himself. We become one body. Love of God and love of neighbor are now truly united." So as a parish family, a parish community, we try to stay united as a loving family. Being united as one doesn't mean that we're all carbon copies of each other. We don't all look alike, dress alike, speak alike. We are of different ages. We come from different cultures, different states, different countries. But we stay united despite our differences. As Pope Benedict said, the celebration of the Mass, gathering around the one table, is a reminder that all the faithful have been united into the body of Christ despite all their differences. And Pope Benedict said, everybody has a place in the church. Every person, without exception, should be made to feel at home and never rejected. And Pope Benedict also said, the Eucharist can never be a private act reserved to people who have been chosen for their similarities or out of friendship. Catholics, the Pope continues, must always be vigilant to ensure that at our every celebration of the Eucharist, all Catholics are welcome. There's a famous quotation from St. Augustine. St. Augustine said, in essential matters, unity. In doubtful matters, freedom. In all things, charity. Pope Francis said, the Eucharist brings us together, young and old, poor and affluent, neighbors and visitors. The Eucharist calls us to see all of them as our brothers and sisters and see in them the face of Christ. First and foremost, always and everywhere, charity, love for one another, is our primary goal as followers of Jesus. Around the year 200, the pagan Tertullian exclaimed, see how those Christians love one another. In the early 100s, less than 100 years after Jesus walked the earth, a Greek philosopher, Aristides, defended Christians in the presence of the Roman Emperor Hadrian. And Aristides said, if one of them is poor and there isn't enough food to go around, they fast several days to give him the food he needs. They are really a new kind of person. There is something divine in them. A new kind of person, something divine in them. A couple of Sundays ago, we celebrated the Feast of Pentecost, and we can think of this divine presence in us as the indwelling Spirit of Jesus. The scriptures say that we are temples of the Holy Spirit. But of course, we also think of the divine presence in us as the Eucharistic presence of Jesus. During the preparation of gifts, the deacon or the priest pours wine and a little water into the chalice and quietly prays, by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Our participation in the Eucharist is an expression of love for one another. We come together as brothers and sisters around our family table, and we share in the divinity of Christ. There truly is something divine in us. And that something is love. Pope Benedict said that the Father is love, Jesus is love, and the Holy Spirit is love. The loving presence of God abides in us. As St. John says in his first letter, God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. And it follows logically that if there is something divine in us, we really should be very different, a new kind of people, a kind of people who radiate the love of God to others. So happy feast again. May the parish of Corpus Christi, the body of Christ, continue to radiate love and unity and joy and peace to all. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us profess our faith by reciting together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And now we place before our Father in heaven all of our special prayers, praying for ourselves, our families, our city, state, and nation, and for all the people of the whole world.
For all and all of us at Corpus Christi, on this our feast day, that we may truly be the body of Christ, the loving presence of God in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are blind to the inherent dignity of every human being, that they may come to recognize the God-given presence and worth of every human person, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the unemployed and those experiencing economic hardship, that the Lord will guide and encourage them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the pandemic, that God will guide and inspire everyone who is working to curtail and eradicate the coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Lord's protection of us and our neighbors against storms and hurricanes, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer with sickness and disability, that the Lord will heal and strengthen them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Jesus will welcome into his eternal kingdom all who have died, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us mention our own personal prayers and intentions. And we pray for our own and for the intentions of one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father in heaven, may we, members of the body of Christ, radiate to others your love and mercy and kindness. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant your church, O Lord, the gifts of unity and peace. The signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present. We pray through Christ our Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away our sins. Happy are we to be called to dine at the banquet of the Lord. We the body of Christ taste and see your goodness. Fill our hearts with the depth of your love. Bind us together as one through your Son. Lord, we are not worthy to receive you into our hearts, but only say the word and we shall be healed of our sins. We, the body of Christ, your goodness, fill our hearts with the depth of your love, bind us together as one through your Son. We have been renewed by the presence of the Lord. God has come to dwell in us, to reveal himself to the world. We, the body of Christ, taste and see your goodness. Fill our hearts with the depth of your love. Bind us together as one through your Son. Prepare our hearts to receive you. Cleanse our minds of sin. Open our hands to embrace you, Lord, to be satisfied with you. We, the body of Christ, taste and see your goodness. Fill our hearts with the depth of your love. Bind us together as one. Bind us together as one. Bind us together as one through your Son.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of a cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one love, by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so, we approach the table of this wonderful sacrament so that, bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heaven realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are holy indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Father, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered by one and by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Father, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her into the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Father, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died. In your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Father, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to share at the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
One breath, one body. sacraments shall cease, may we be one with all your saints above, one with your saints in one unending peace, one with your saints in one unbounded love. Oh, may we all one bread, one body be, through this blessed sacrament of unity.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.